when American troops invaded Iraq and invaded through Mosul, they invaded through my town, and the town that I was born and raised in was completely ransacked, demolished, destroyed, everything. It was just constant firefights, explosions going off 24/7, but that's just how it was. It was normal at that point. Having to experience that is very humbling. A lot of people were born in a nice environment. They didn't have to worry about when their next meal was. It was very, very hectic. The sun never rose. It was always grim skies and just horrible. No quiet, no peace. Just always loud noise, people screaming, people yelling, crying. That's just how it was. The war was just one factor of my life. It was, at that point, it was just normal. You got used to it. The worst thing that happened to me was getting stage 4 cancer. And that's the hardest thing that happened. That was 10 times worse than the war. At that point, there was no such thing as war. It was just, will I die or will I live? I was only able to get 3 rounds of chemo, but that was after being denied by 7 different hospitals because they told my parents that your son is already dead. He has 3% chance to live, and it's stage 4 already. So there's no point of us even doing any operation on him because it'd be a waste of time and a waste of money. Your son is just dead, so you might as well just go enjoy your time with him, go say some prayers, and get a funeral ready for him. My parents are the strongest people mentally and physically that I know, and they couldn't see another person, let alone their own son, die. They've seen too much death, too much war, too much chaos, and this was just an even bigger factor, let alone be their own son. There was absolutely no way they were gonna let their son die. We knew that Iraq was not gonna help us. We knew that the Iraq hospitals were not up to standard, and we knew for a fact they didn't have the materials, the funding to save me. My dad knew that America was freedom and safety. If we can make it to America, we can save our son. They said, we have to get to America and at least try there because we know America will not fail us and give up on us like Iraq did. America will actually try their best to save me. We moved to Turkey at first because we had to escape Iraq. So we moved to Turkey and lived there for a year, and we tried Turkish hospitals to try and see if they were able to at least treat me. We knew they couldn't cure me or help me, but at least treat me to give me more opportunity to live longer until we could hopefully reach America. Turkey was the same situation. One, us being Catholic at the time, they didn't like that. And two, Turkey said the same thing. They said, the Turkish doctor said, your son is already dead. There's no point in you guys even trying. Pray to God and pray that he makes it to heaven. You might as well bury him. So the only option in our mind is America. We immigrated to California, and right away, first thing I remember, actually, I don't remember anything of Cali besides landing in Cali. First thing I remember is waking up in the hospital, me being 3 years old at the time, waking up in the hospital, in a hospital bed, my mom's to my right crying. I stand up, and I'm like, Mom, why are you crying, Mom? And I look around, and there's doctors just walking past, back and forth talking. I couldn't understand at the time, but I'm like, Mom, why are you crying? I'm like, Mom, what's this thing strapped up to my arm? They had an IV bag, and she's like, don't worry, it's okay. Just lay down and go back to sleep. It'll be okay. And then from there, it started the process of me being in the hospital for 6 months at a time, not knowing what's going on, but just constantly getting treatment, getting chemo done, losing my hair every single time it grew, always being strapped up to an IV bag, getting shots, and then always being put to sleep, never knowing what was happening whenever I woke up. It was just always, it's gonna be okay, it's gonna be okay, and just let it be. So ultimately I got the treatment here in America. America saved me.